Hey guys, welcome to the podcast of the Telangana history on our YouTube channel, Lucky Podcasts. Our narration is based on the textbooks of the Telugu Academy, narrated by John Michael and produced by Gujjula Chandra Shekar. Chapter 10, Part 4. Sri Krishna Committee Report. On 3rd February 2010, the central government constituted the 5-member Sri Krishna Committee under the leadership of Justice B.N. Sri Krishna to look into Telangana issue. This committee toured extensively around Telangana and gathered information from different sections of society. They have collected nearly 1 lakh memorandums. On 30th December 2011, the committee submitted 505 pages report in 2 volumes to the Home Minister. The committee suggested 6 solutions to the Telangana problem. They are 1. To keep the state united. 2. To divide the state and make Hyderabad as union territory and keep combined capital city for both the states. 3. To constitute Rayala Telangana clubbing both Rayalaseema and Telangana and make Kostalandhra a separate state. Hyderabad to be made a part of Rayala Telangana. 4. To divide state into Simandhra and Telangana and make Hyderabad an union territory. 5. To divide state into Simandhra and Telangana, making Hyderabad as the capital city of Telangana and look for a new capital for Simandhra. 6. To keep the state unified and suggested measures for socio-economic development and political empowerment of Telangana region through statutorily empowered Telangana Regional Council. However, diversified opinions were expressed by Telangana people that this is another deceitful act. High Court also commented that the Sri Krishna Committee exceeded its limits. The crucial 8th chapter of report could not be made public after the court gave a stayed order. This committee also did not fulfill the aspirations of the Telangana people. Telangana Joint Action Committee. Telangana Joint Action Committee, TJAC, was formed with all the organizations, all sections who are fighting for the cause of Telangana, with an aim of bringing them under a single umbrella. Professor Kodandaram was elected as its chairman. All the major political parties became partners in this JAC. The spree of joint action spread to all the universities. Usmania University, Kakatiya University, Palamur University, Satavahana University, Mahatma Gandhi University formed their student joint action committees. The employees' JACs, lawyers' JACs, JACs of caste or communities were also formed. JAC carried its struggle through different types of protests. They organized protests at mandal and village level also. The speciality of the movement, unlike 1969 movement, was that it did not turn into violent movement due to the efforts of the leaders. By forming into cultural troops, dhoomdhams, and singing the songs in praise of Telangana, they kindled the fire of people's aspirations for separate state for Telangana. Prominent artists of Telangana like Gadar, Andesri, Gorati Venkanna, Goda Anjaya, Rasamai Balakrishnan, Jayaraj, Deshapati Srinivas, and others have played significant role in the dhoomdham and other cultural programs and inspired the people. Vimalakka also played a very crucial role in the movement by singing songs and performing other art forms. Mass protest in Telangana. People resorted to mass protest methods to express their demand through cultural programs, dhoomdhams and songs. The more interesting programs include the Vanta Varpu, the cooking food on roads and highways, and played Batukamma and sports on the streets and roads. Telangana Vidyavantula Vedika, Dalit, Adivasi and women organizations, Lambada Porata Hakkula Sangam, Tudumdabba, Gond organizations, Nayak Podu associations, Adivasi and women organizations, Lambada Porata Hakkula Sangam, Tudumdabba, Gond organizations, Nayak Podu associations, Adivasi Udyama Porata Samiti, Dandora, Mala Mahanadu, All Mala Student Association, Dalit student organizations in different universities, Telangana Jagruti, Ammala Sangam have played very important role in creating awareness among Telangana people for separate statehood. Tribal and caste agitations. Tribal and caste organizations such as Tudumdabba, Lambadi Nagarabheri, and Erukula Kurru, etc., organized their protests demanding Telangana state. Madiga Dandora, Kurumal Golladolu Dabba, and Mokudabba were formed. The caste professionals such as toddy tappers, sheep grower, weaving, fishing, and washerman communities also actively participated in the movement. Non-cooperation movement. On 17 February 2011, a non-cooperation movement was started in which more than 3 lakh government employees participated. This movement lasted for 16 days, causing loss of revenue to the extent of 8 billion rupees per day to the government. In the months of February and March, assembly sessions were also boycotted for weeks by Telangana representatives. Mass resignation of Telangana members of assembly, July 2011. In the month of July 2011, 81 out of 119 Telangana MLAs, 12 out of 15 Telangana ministers, 13 Lok Sabha members out of 17, 1 Congress MP in Rajya Sabha, and 20 MLCs resigned their positions in protest against the delay in formation of Telangana state. However, speakers of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and state did not accept their resignations. Sakala Janula Samme, All People Strike, 11 September 2011 to October 2011. The most significant phase in Telangana movement has Sakala Janula Samme, in which all the sections of the people, caste groups, government and private employees, various organizations under the leadership of Telangana Joint Action Committee resorted to strike on 13 September 2011. Educational institutions were closed down, RTC buses were stopped, government offices were closed down, lawyers boycotted courts, government employees voluntarily boycotted their duties and participated in protests. Coal mine workers participated in the strike enthusiastically. Entire Telangana expressed its aspiration of separate state. In fact, people's life came to stand still. TJAC called off strike after 18 days. TJAC chairman Professor Kodandram declared that though the strike was called off, the protests will go on till they achieve the Telangana state. Police registered cases on the leaders, students, and all those who participated in the strike. Later, BJP leader Kishan Reddy started the march in January 2012. He toured extensively all over Telangana for 22 days. The freedom fighter Konda Lakshman Bapuji, at the age of 97, participated in the Satyagraha at Jantar Mantar in New Delhi. Million March, 10th March 2011. Million March was organized by Telangana JSC in Hyderabad on 10th March 2011 on the lines of Tahrir Square in Cairo, Egypt. This march was against the delay in formation of the separate Telangana state by the center. Telangana ministers and various parties supported the march. The police did not give permission, apprehending the violence on the assets of Andhra people. In order to disrupt the march, police arrested thousands of activists throughout the state and closed down all entry points into Hyderabad city. When TJAC promised to conduct the march peacefully, the police accepted for the march to be conducted only on Tank Bund, Necklace Road from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. Though the permission was given, police tried to stop it and all trains were cancelled. Usmania University was closed down. In spite of all these restrictions, around 5 lakh people reached Tank Bund, and by evening, 2 more lakh people joined the march. Telangana songs, Bonalu, Batukamma, and other cultural programs were performed. An incident of putting fire to a media van erupted the chaos. The police released tear gas, used water cannons to disperse the agitators. In spite of this, they continued their march till midnight. Later, on 30th September 2012, TJAC organized Sagaraharam to express the desire for separate Telangana state. Formation of Telangana state. Recognizing the intensity of the movement, the central government called for all-party meeting on 28th December 2012. Representatives of 8 main political parties attended the meeting. The parties such as MIM, CPM opposed the Telangana state. YSR Congress maintained its silence. The Congress party members of Simandra opposed the division of state. All the Telangana leaders supported it. Telugu Desam party reiterated that it was abided by its earlier decision to the Telangana in its letter written to Pranab Mukherjee in the year 2008. After the meeting, Center declared that within a month, a positive decision will be taken up. After that, Congress core committee under the chairperson of Srimati Indira Gandhi discussed the Telangana matter and finally resolved to divide the state. Andhra leaders tried their maximum to stop the formation. Later, the bill was passed in parliament, stating the formation of Telangana state comprises of 10 districts and Hyderabad as unified capital for both the states for 10 years. All the political parties in UPA and BJP, BSP, CPI supported the bill. And on 18th February 2014, the bill was passed in Lok Sabha. And on 20th February 2014, the Raj Sabha also supported it. President gave his assent to the bill on 1st March 2014. Summary. Realizing the aspirations of Telangana people and as a symbol of the eternal spirit of the leaders of the movement, Telangana emerged as the 29th state of India on 2nd June 2014. In its 65th year of democracy, the Indian Parliament passed the Act of Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Bill 2014. The Telangana movement for separate state is rooted in historical context. Spreading over 60 years, it developed into a unique political movement. It was hailed by many intellectuals as a symbol of democratic struggle against political domination and economic exploitation. End of part 4 of chapter 10. In the next podcast, you listen about the 4 founding fathers of Telangana. For more such audio content, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Lucky Podcasts.